Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. Today we are going to learn a very interesting topic, that is the perfume and perfume ingredients which are listed as allergens in the EU regulations. So let us first try to understand what is a perfume and fragrance. Now, fragrance substances are naturally or synthetically derived organic compounds with a characteristic, usually very pleasant smell. A fragrance formula may contain up to several hundreds or more different ingredients. Special fragrances databases list more than 2,587 fragrance ingredients used for perfuming. Now, all of us use the perfumes which are naturally or synthetically derived. There are large number of databases. You will be surprised to know that there are more than 2,500 fragrance ingredients which are being used for perfuming. So again, this is a very big industry, and it is a very pleasant industry, you can say. Now, what is the problem associated with the fragrances? What are the things to be considered when you are using any perfume? What are the side effects of using any perfumes? As a cosmetic formulator, one must be aware about all the pros and cons of the perfumes. So the very first problem which is being highlighted whenever we talk about the perfumes is the contact allergy to fragrance ingredients, which usually occurs when a susceptible individual has been exposed on the skin to the fragrance allergen. For example, through their presence in a cosmetic product. A large number of products use perfumes. Even not only it is limited to the cosmetics, but to a variety of products, even to the soaps, even to the sanitizers, even to large number of washing powders, detergents, etc. Now, fragrances are basically complex combinations of natural or man-made substances which are added to many consumer products. Now, what is the purpose of adding them? There are various purposes for which the fragrances have been added into cosmetic and other products. For example, to give them a distinctive smell, pleasant smell, or to impart a pleasant odor, mask the inherent smell of some ingredients. Sometimes they are also used to mask the inherent smell of some ingredients. At the same time, enhancing the experience of the product user. It also creates important olfactory benefits that are ubiquitous, tangible, and valued. Now, perfumes are a mixture of fragrant essential oils or aromatic compounds, fixative and solvents used to give the human body, animal, food objects, and living species a pleasant smell. It has been used for centuries by the mankind. Perfumes are supposed to release a continuous pleasant fragrance that will provide a long-lasting feeling of freshness. Initially, it was only used for religious purposes, but now it has become an ornament of sophistication for both men and women. So you can understand the perfume industry these days. It is not only being used by the women, it is also used by the men. Initially, it started for the religious purpose in the form of the various sticks. Now, fragrances in most of the type of the cosmetics and skin care products includes like perfumes, shampoos, conditioners, moisturizers, facial, cosmetics, and deodorants. There are more than 5,000 different fragrances which are present. Now, the main problem associated with the use of the perfume is the contact dermatitis, contact allergy. Now, allergic contact dermatitis to fragrance ingredients is one of the most often caused by the exposure to the cosmetics, and predominantly it involves the face, armpits, or the hands. The disease can be severe and generalized with a significant impairment of the quality of life and potential consequences for fitness of the work. So one has to be very particular about what kind of the perfume to be used, whether you are allergic to that perfume or not. One has to find out the, sometimes we are not sure of the reasons of suffering. So one has to be particular whenever you are applying any cosmetic to your skin. One has to be, as a cosmetic formulator, you have to be very particular what are the main effects or the side effects associated with that particular cosmetics. Now, apart from the allergic contact dermatitis, fragrances in the perfumes and cosmetic products can also provoke irritant contact dermatitis, immediate contact reactions, contact urticaria, pigmented contact dermatitis, or photosensitivity. So you can yourself understand the harmful effects like photosensitivity, contact dermatitis, pigmented contact dermatitis. So in a way, this is not acceptable from any cosmetic ingredient before being application. Now let us try to understand the cosmetic allergens. Cosmetic allergens is basically referred to as an abnormal reaction of the body to a previously encountered allergen introduced either by inhalation or ingestion and skin contact. The symptoms may include like itchy eyes, running nose, wheezing, skin rashes and diarrhea. So when we talk about the perfumes, we need to understand what do we understand by the cosmetic allergens, what are the symptoms associated and caused by these allergens. Since we have to understand the list of the ingredients being used by the European Union, we need to understand the paragraph 49 of the regulation of 1223-2009. Which of the preamble, which clearly states that a number of substances have been identified by the committee as likely to cause allergic reactions, and it will be necessary to restrict their use or impose certain conditions concerning them. They are very much particular about the harmful effects caused by these ingredients, and there is an urgent need to identify these allergens which are having such kind of effects on the humans or on the animals or likely to cause such kind of effects. In order to ensure that consumers are adequately informed, the presence of these substances should be mentioned in the list of ingredients. So whenever they are being used into the perfumes, they need to be highlighted. They need to be mentioned on the label itself, and consumer attention should be drawn to the presence of these ingredients. So there should be a very well awareness about the use of such kind of the ingredients which can cause the contact dermatitis. So the you need to create awareness among the people as well for the use of such kind of the ingredients which are being used in a large number of the perfumes or fragrances. This information should improve the diagnosis of contact allergies among consumers and should enable them to avoid the use of cosmetic products which they do not tolerate. So one must be clear about the use of these perfumes, these ingredients, whether it is being present into the labeling part of that perfume or not. If the person is allergic to that particular ingredient, that perfume should be avoided. Now, the perfume ingredients listed as allergens in EU regulations. The cosmetic regulation of 2009 clearly lists down the 26 most known allergenic substances. These substances must appear on the label of your cosmetic product when present in the finished formula at certain threshold. What does the certain threshold here mean? It clearly means the quantity needs to be mentioned along with the ingredient. If it is crossing a certain acceptable limits, that products should be avoided. There has been limit as well as the specification about those 26 allergens which are known to be having harmful dermatitis issues. Although the word allergen doesn't appear in the European Union cosmetic regulation, the 26 substances listed in Annex 3 of the regulations are known for their allergenic potential and are under the regulatory framework because of it. So an allergen is commonly defined as any substance, often a protein, that can induce an allergy. Very simple definition. Against the European Union cosmetic regulations, whereby 26 substances have been highlighted in the Annex 3 of the regulation. Now they are regulated cosmetic allergen, considered as a regulated under current European Union cosmetic regulations of 2009. So the concentration exceeds, when we talk about the leave-on products like moisturizers which you leave on the skin, the concentration permitted is 0.001%. And when we talk about the shampoos which are being rinsed off, they do not stay on the body, they are being rinsed off, the concentration permitted is 0.01%. Now there are certain combinations which are used to test these fragrance allergies. The formula is listed on the screen. You can see that there are two types of the mix which are being tested to try to understand the allergies caused by those 26 ingredients, whether they are falling into the specification or going out of the specifications, to how much extent is severity of that particular ingredient. So there are two combinations which are generally being used, fragrance mix 1 and fragrance mix 2. So fragrance mix 1, you can say a number of alcohol derivatives, a number of fragrances, essential oils are being used like eugenol, geraniol, oak moss. This combination is tried for and tested for each ingredient to understand the severity of the contact dermatitis known. This is the fragrance 2 mixture 2 consisting of citral, citronellal, like cinnamaldehyde, etc. So the purpose of undertaking this work is to ensure and to identify each ingredients which are to be selected to be included in the present opinion and classified in one of the categories defined below. So let us understand these categories. The first category is the established contact allergen in humans. So whenever any ingredient is being used, it has to be clearly aware that which it lies into any one of these categories, whether it is lying into the contact allergen in humans, or second category is the established contact allergen in animals. So they comprises of the list of the ingredients which abide by that category. For example, the established contact allergen in humans are the identified ingredients which needs to be labeled out very well, which are known to have the potential of causing allergies in humans. Second list comprises of the allergies causing substances in animals. Similarly, the C part is the likely contact allergen, not having that much severity, but it is likely if human, animal or other evidence is considered. And last category is the possible contact allergen if human, animal and other evidence is being considered. So four categories, clear cut, four categories are there. First is the established contact allergen in humans. Second is the established contact allergen in animals. And third is the likely contact allergen. And last is the possible contact allergen. So here is the list of 26 contact allergens. This comprises of these substances like amyls in animal. One must be particular of noticing these ingredients into your perfume, whatever perfume you are using. Like amyls in animal, this is the list which is being issued by the European Union list of allergens in their annexure 3 part. Benzyl alcohol, coumarins, cinnamyl alcohol, citral, eugenol, hydroxycitronol, isoeugenol, amylsin, amyl alcohol, benzyl salicylate, cinnamyl, coumarin, geraniol, anisyl alcohol, benzyl cinnamate, farnesol, linalool, benzyl benzoate, citronellol, limonene, methyl heptene carbonate and hexyl cinnamon aldehyde. Now, apart from that, the additional compounds which are to be considered, 6 additional compounds were also analyzed. 4 cosmetic allergens not yet regulated under the current European Union cosmetic, they are not into this list right now, and 2 other compounds that are having the even carcinogenicity potential. They are like methyl eugenyl and 4-allyl anisole. These 2 products have ingredients have been identified as a potential carcinogen. So you can understand the severity. Whatever ingredients are being used on the skin, they must be free from such potentials, because cosmetics are being utilized to enhance the beauty. So if the purpose is not fulfilled out, we need to identify and create awareness about the use of such kind of the ingredients into the perfume industry. This is the list of additional compounds which have been not yet included into the list but are having potential attributes like that, like etranol, chloroetranol, methyl 2, nanonate, phenyl acetaldehyde, etc. Additional compound which I have told is the methyl eugenol, 4-allyl anisole. These are but have the potential of causing the carcinogenicity. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope I am clear with the list of the ingredients as per the European Union to be abided. Please like, share and comment in the comment box. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.